It's a Sean, in case you didn't know. Found an old brigader from the old days. PhD 20. PhD 20. Did he change his name or was it always that? Anyway, he's talking about narration versus comparison.
Welcome to PhD and D on YouTube and a video looking at comparison versus narration. As a DM, it's very easy to start to compare things to real-life familiar events. Events or sensations, images, smells, sounds, everything that are familiar to a player versus actually narrating them out. So my advice is to avoid the comparison and just dive into the narration, as I think the narration is always going to actually be stronger in, you know, invoking that imagination and getting the immersion that you're wanting out of your game. So an example would be, and the best example I can come up with right now, is at sunset. As the sun is setting and the sun gets just below the horizon, you can see the outlines of trees and buildings, but you can't see any features. There's not enough light at this point. They all just look, and there's enough light behind them that they just look black. They look like they're painted on the horizon, versus when there's enough light, you can see features on them. In a game, it would be very easy to be describing to the players, you're walking down this road and the sun is setting, and you know how when the sun sets and there's just light behind things and they just look black, that you can't see any features. That's what this looks like right now. So right there, you've cut out of the narration. You're talking directly to the players saying, do you remember, not your character, do you specifically know? And for me, as a GM, I've done that. I know I have, but it really took to heart how ineffective that is when I experienced that as a player and a friend picked up and he used that as a DM, and he probably learned it from me, but I didn't like that. And so I started to kind of try to revert away from that. And I've caught myself recently doing it again and trying to compare things, but try to stay away from that. So it may be better put as you're walking down the road and the sun has set just below the horizon. The sky is a dark blue above you as it fades into a lighter mix of gray and orange near where the sun has set, creating this illusion that the trees and the ruins up ahead are painted black on the sky and don't actually exist. Something like that versus cutting out a game and saying, okay, do you know what this and this is? Or you know what a pig farm smells like? That's what it smells like.
You ever been to Mono Lake? You ever been to the Salton Sea?
Here. And even as far as that, just say, you know, it smells like a pig farm if you want to do that. Just tell them. Don't try to invoke their memories as players. And if feel free to disagree and comment below on why you do, or comment below on why you agree. But that's my tip for the day. Narrate. Don't compare. Draws you out of the game, draws you out of the immersion. And in my experience, it's just not as rich as that full-on narration can be. This has been PhD and D. Thanks for watching.
Okay, he used to call himself PhD and D. Now he's called PhD 20. Okay. So he was from the brigade days. This is how our videos all looked back then. We would say something in like 5 minutes, and then there would be a rebuttal, video response kind of thing. Anyway, here's my response 10 years ago. You're in a spaceship like the one used in Silent Running. Arg. I hate when players do that, or the GM does that. Like in that movie Aliens, you know? It's like that. It's like that in the game. Anyway.